now. Like, they are just dominating the early game, but don't count out Simp. Don't count him out, Simp. What a play there.
Oh boy, Mack, big wins. aBeZy though. Just too dangerous on all fronts. The man is a machine.
Left on the clock. Absolutely slated.
Unbelievable stuff from Atlanta FaZe. Any moment now, second tick, there it goes. Oh boy, it's flying by. Speaking of flying, here comes Arcitys. Woohoo! That's a clean B. Oh, baby. Takes a lot of effort to kill these boys of FaZe.
It has been a wild start to day three of Major 2. Keep the insanity up. Let's keep it going. Ultra versus FaZe. I don't think this one was a lock for me to be as insane as that first series, but Ultra, they've got a chance to do it here. But Joe, first, let's look at FaZe so far. They've been very good.
Well, this is the reason why we don't think it may not be as crazy as that is FaZe's first overall. They're first in SD. They're first in Hardpoint. They're the best attacking team, and it's by far. And don't worry, this isn't the only page. We got more.
That's only
of
page
it.
One?
We're going to keep going. They're first in control. I mean, they're the best. It's just played. They have one loss on the year. They come back from that loss. They destroy everybody in their way. I think for everyone, they are without a doubt the favorite to win this tournament. Can Toronto keep this up, though, is the question.
Very true, but let's take a look at the social soundboard presented by Astro. It's going to be Arcitys of FaZe. Warmed up Dallas and Seattle today. Put us on payroll. Let me know if any teams want to warm up. So yesterday, the squads that got the W.
Yeah,
they do the warm-up games with them as a lot of the teams off. We'll do that. And yeah, I mean, I'm sure it helps to, you know, play against the best team, because anything you're going to play after that's going to seem a lot easier.
Yeah, I mean, I guess. Yeah, but as you said, you know the formula works. You got to play FaZe the day of your match. I don't know who they warmed up today, but, man, it should be a very good match in Atlanta FaZe. I mean, they are absolutely the favorites there, but, they have to focus. Toronto Ultra, they got it going the other day. They're playing really well in respawns. They were able to take two away from OpTic. They clutched up in that search and destroy, and it's a little bit of what we saw from that stage one, you know, throughout, where they were close, but those close moments against the top teams, they couldn't find. Yesterday, they found those.
See if they can keep doing it, but let's start with FaZe. They're first in just about every statistical category, as we just showed. Let's see if they come out hot. Take a look at the squad. This is the Atlanta FaZe.
Atlanta, Georgia, you magnificent beast, you. This is 2021, baby. And the 2021 Atlanta FaZe are stacked. We got us a member of the Scuff Team of the Year by the name of Simp.
Grabs the bomb, 10 seconds left, and he realizes he can't get to the other side.
The other battle-hardened returnees are aBeZy and Cellium.
Pull away! Cellium! No, he's not even shut down! aBeZy doesn't even need to go vents!
Arcitys is here.
Can he get the angle over the top? He gets the kill! Arcitys with the 1v2 clutch!
Atlanta FaZe.
Team is so stacked, Joe, that sometimes it's like hard to give everyone credit. Like, you know, whether it's sports or esports, you know, you focus on the superstars at time. They get talked about the most. You talk about their stats and what they're doing for their team. But like, they all kind of do that.
Yeah, all of them.
Yeah.
It's really just, it's just talent from top to bottom. And, you know, the big story was obviously the addition of Arcitys coming onto this roster, making sure they were focused, their fundamentals were on point, and they have showed that this year. But the other three, the Tiny Terrors, Cellium, we're going to show his stats here in a little bit, but, I mean, they are just rolling right now. There's nothing really else to say.
Yeah, there was one match I casted where I was like, I feel like I really didn't talk about so much. Like, the focus was on aBeZy at the entry and some rotations from Arcitys. I'm like, and he had a 1-3. Like, it's insane some of the stuff that they're able to put up, and that's why it's going to be such a tough test for Ultra in this matchup. But as Joe said, they're starting to click. They're starting to clutch in the moments they need to. Let's check out Toronto Ultra. Well, Joe, I think with the change happened, there are some questions, right, from the community with methods off the squad. It's tough to make a decision on how you think they made the right call. But now, you know, we're what, about a month removed from that? You've seen a lot of gameplay. What are your thoughts now?
Well, I mean, the series that defines it is yesterday for me. There were those moments against the best teams. They were just joking. And I don't think it was a methods thing versus an inside thing. I don't exactly know. I think it was a communication thing. Somebody was freaking out. Whatever that was, it feels like they learned from that as we take a look at our maps and modes. But they learned from that. You saw that Amy Long route on that raid hardpoint, which how many close raids did they have? But that was really it. It feels like they've learned from that. They're starting to grow a little bit. That's the keys for me for Toronto Ultra.
Yeah, it's not, you kind of nailed it. It's not necessarily an individual problem sometimes. Like, do I think Major Maniac personally was responsible for Røkkr's woes? No, I do not. I think he's an incredible player, and I don't think he was the problem necessarily. It's just there needed to be a change in dynamic, a change in the roles, and maybe the same case for Ultra here. As it seems, just maybe. They're starting to improve and contend with the top dogs, but I think you nailed it. That last series is what defines them right now. Imagine you come in here, you go through OpTic, and you go through FaZe. What an unbelievable result this could end up being. Kleenex, nice opener there with two. The solo sub takes out the two super subs on FaZe.
Yeah, a nice start here. Arcitys would be the last one down. Kleenex starts off 3-0. Map records, this is... FaZe is one of their best hard points, 4-0 on Moscow, 1-1 for Toronto Ultra. And obviously, you know, Toronto Ultra, what do they do? They get rid of Garrison. They don't want to play Garrison against this team. And FaZe, they don't want to play Raid. Why would you play Raid? You saw what they were able to do yesterday. You know, you've beaten them on Raid hardpoint before, but it's just one of those maps where if things don't go your way or if there's one play made, that's the difference. As Atlanta FaZe, they fight on back. They're able to get some of this time. They flip the spawns. Huge. Out of FaZe.
I think that's one of the advantages you have when you have a really wide map pool, whereas like OpTic made the choice to play them there because it was one of their strong maps and maybe they didn't have another one they wanted to go to instead, like a Garrison or something. FaZe are more comfortable playing kind of anywhere, so it makes it a little bit easier to get rid of team's strong maps.
Yes, I could go on a rant about that for an hour. You know about that. But into this second hill, FaZe, they have the spawns. They get three kills. The first push is held by Atlanta FaZe. Got some good time. They got trophies down. Cammy's just waiting for his teammates right now. They're going to try and go all the way back, but there's only 35 seconds left. They have to keep an eye on that. FaZe can flip these spawns and get them spawned towards the back, and this might happen. They might start getting aggressive. Look at all the red arrows start to push, but they still spawn safe. There was the chance that those players spawn under police, and that gets a little scary.
Yeah, if they had anyone a little bit more forward, like if they pushed out a little bit quicker, maybe they could have done it, but just didn't have enough time.
Well, that's too bad.
As soon as I was saying that, I was like, all right, well, never mind. It's kind of happening. So two will spawn out. Split right now for Ultra. Of your phase, it can be a little bit tricky. You know you have advantage here pushing forward, but you have to worry about that timing on the players coming on the flank. Cammy, set up in the back. Fantastic job to hold here for now.
One's pinching. Now look at the play by Simp. Simp takes the long route. He goes all the way around. He hits the shots. They know there's one more player, and they take their time. While that happens, Cellium, he's able to take down two as well. Make it the third. You said it. So, they knew the timings. They knew those timings. They turn around. The player's able to find those kills.
This is what I'm talking about. Sometimes you just don't see it. Like, we're not on Cellium's POV. He's on a FaZe 8-2 on a 4-spree. He's killed three people. Like, it's just you lose it in the background of how talented this squad could be. It's tough to pick who to watch sometimes, and he lights it up. Three huge kills, five in a row now for Cell. Locking down the point and the scoreline. Already starting to get a little ugly.
Yeah, you're up to five in a row now. I think for Cell, you definitely play around these streets. You already have bus control for Simp. He rotates early. Here comes a push on the street. That's going to be two dead. So, Ultra, you're also getting out-rotated when you're not even earning the time. And look at this. They know the spawns. Immediately, Simp turns around. Cellium has an idea that they could push him at old. They trap them inside a bank. There's a bit of a split here, but they read it. I mean, just look at it. Look at his streak. 7-12 in a row as the team. Finally, Cammy's able to get one for Toronto.
Well, Joe, the last time these guys played, and that it was a 3-0 just spanking. I mean, the series was freer than healthcare in Canada. That's when we went to listen in with Ultra, and they were, like, dead, right?
Yes, it was not pretty.
So I'm curious, like, is it improved, right? It's got to be better than when we last heard it. Let's go to an Astro listening with Toronto Ultra.
Yeah, they're going to push out.
I might need to touch on that.
Glass.
Really weak.
I pushed.
I'll help you.
Simp, I'll help him.
Bring this back.
I will help him.
Simp, one shot. Fuck.
Where's Cell?
Cell was there as well. There was two on.
He's out too.
I spawned. Yeah, I spawned.
Out. Three glove.
Got one.
Yeah, Cell. I'm
watch. I can't manage. Kill me in the back.
I spawned bank.
What's calling me?
Absolutely. Two on time. One old
as well.
I'll pinch me.
On pillar.
Him. Might just chow me in time.
Yeah, he will be. Veski's with you.
I'll flash the cam.
Cellium dead in time. No more aBeZy. Stuck him.
Nice, flash cap.
I'm already pushed out right. I'm deep right.
Yeah.
Could be Glove.
Arcitys is playing bus stop. He's challenging.
I can get mid cup.
Street, Arcitys.
Sim weak.
One more push.
Arcitys was street.
He's flanking me on. I'm dead.
Glove. Yeah, I'll get you pushed. He's shot me.
One's planting, one's on time.
aBeZy in time.
I'm not sure.
aBeZy was in time.
Listen, take our time here. Don't take any single gels.
On the right. He's close left as well.
Well, Joe, I think the energy may be a little bit better than that last one we heard, but anything else to take away?
Yeah, it's like tight. You know, you join a listen in, they're down 100. You can kind of tell, right, that there's just sort of like, you're hearing a couple, all right, we could do this. But there's also, as soon as they say that, three go down, it's like there's definitely some frustration. I mean, they're just getting destroyed. That's just what it is. This is beautiful hard point out of Atlanta FaZe. They flip the spawns again. You're able to get some pressure, at least through the front by Cammy. He's going to be the first one on the point. aBeZy, he knows the pressure is going to be right there. And well, they're just going to handle it. FaZe up 130 points. It's beautiful to watch, but man, do they smoke some teams.
No, Joe and I had this conversation before the match, and we said, like, it can be really fun to watch, like, cast FaZe and watch them because it's, like, it's so impressive at times. Like, they're so in sync, they're so talented that it's, like, it's fun to watch in a way. But at the same time, it's, like, sometimes they just beat people so badly that it's not like last series where it's, like, you know, intense and screaming and wild. It's just so impressive.
Yeah, it's just their ability, you know, I think it just comes down to their practice, right? Just, you know, to bring those fundamentals. Nobody wants to die there. So basically, Simp doesn't want to spawn out. He wants to make sure Cammy has a long route all the way across the map. Or maybe he's just toying with him. I'm glad
you kind of said that, because I feel like if you're a new viewer, you'd be like, what the hell is going on? Are these guys working together?
Well, so Simp's either messing with him, which, you know, they've been known to assassinate people from time to time. Or, yeah, it's like he was hoping that spawn a little bit closer, but artillery is in. So get them off the point. But everybody alive right now for Ultra. I mean, I guess you just kind of take this if you're FaZe. You at least know where they're at. Cellium is able to get that trade. And then Arcee's looking over aBeZy. That's going to be three dead. The last player banned. You still have the close spawns. aBeZy just trying to play his life right now.
Continue to try and hold it down. But the pinch comes in. Insight does get two kills, so they'll get back onto the point, but not much time to really earn there anyway. But Insight on rotation gets a big one. Just tries to clear out this side of the bus so they can get set up here in the street. RC's through with the trade. Everybody looking at Kleenex. He at least is able to take down one, but the flood of FaZe players is here. One is going to spawn on the opposite side from Ultra. So I was going to say a pinch is kind of brewing, but they kill one side of the pinch. So you'll comfortably get inside of the point now if you're FaZe with 20 points to go to close it out. And aBeZy, hell of a map. 23-11, minute 22 on the objective.
Yeah, just 16 seconds away. At least have the contest right now. Kleenex is going to get aggressive. A pinch coming in from Vance all the way through middle of the map. Insight, nice shots with that grade. Just, you know, just maybe warming up a little bit if you're Ultra. There we go, getting some kills. And I think that's really it at this point. I think they kind of know how difficult it would be to win this map. It's pretty much impossible, but maybe just, you know, get warmed up. The comms are probably back and forth. Just, you know what, just focus on the next map. Do what we have to do.
100%. Get a spree going. Keep the
make
gun
this
hot.
Interesting. Yeah, make this interesting.
Maybe smoke somebody, get a little confidence if you're able to. But three drop there for Ultra. So get Ace to 240, and aBeZy still on a tear. 26-12 now as he's inside of the hard point. Little split spawn again from Ultra, but it's picked up. Cellium gets two. Last guy was the guy that spawned out. That's Vance. Simp has got the position through the mid cut. And it is a 250 to 113 victory once they get the point. They did not get the point, so I just lied.
It's 250 to 114.
I'm sorry, that 114.
Aha! La la, pants on fire.
But, I mean, it was comfortable. They were up 100 after the first, three hard points. And where it kind of unraveled was, you know, we say this on Moscow, when you're able to chain together two and three, a lot of times it'll create a big gap, either lead to a lot of separation or a big comeback. There it was so early in the game, they go up 100 before you think the map starts. It's a phase one in map one.
I mean, it just starts with that second hill, actually, right? They get flipped right away. You have good side, you want the sponge, you want the second hill. You're hoping to chain those first two hills together. And yeah, as you said, they basically lose three in a row. I mean, out of the break, it was looking good.
That's worse than I said.
Three, four down. It wasn't pretty. Here's a look at the stats. I mean, it's going to look real good on one side, not so good on the other. aBeZy leading the way, 27 kills, but everybody over 3,000 damage for Atlanta FaZe.
Impressive start, and I think what you would expect from FaZe, you know, they've been sitting, watching, waiting, the favorite coming into this, just ready to go. And, you know, maybe they thought they were throwing a little bit of a curveball in the sense maybe they thought they might be playing OpTic Ultra come in with the upset.
For OpTic, 100%.
100%. So throwing a little bit of a curveball changes the preparation a bit, but doesn't seem to matter much. They get the map one win. Do a quick break. We'll be right back.
Call of Duty League is presented by T-Mobile, now America's largest and fastest 5G network. Set your sights on the competition with T-Mobile, the leader in 5G. SCUF, the official controller of the Call of Duty League. The Call of Duty League is presented by USAA Insurance. We offer insurance that's made for the military community to help them easily protect what they've worked hard for.
FaZe come out map one, hit Ultra with the Hammer of Thor. They dominate on Moscow. Now we go to Search and Destroy, where FaZe, you know, for a long time looked unbeatable. They were the best team there. They have some slip-ups. They lose a couple Search and Destroys. Ultra has always been a threat in that mode, so maybe a chance here. But Joe, if you could take me through the game fuel keys to victory, I'd appreciate it.
Yeah, I mean, first things first, something's got to improve. They got 3-0'd last time they played, and they outslayed by 57 kills across three maps. That's just got to be better. Map one, it was not. Defense, Destiny needs to be better. They're ninth in the CDL. FaZe is first, and it is by a wide margin. What you're hoping to do is you have a strong defense, you force FaZe to get uncomfortable, maybe play off of their defaults. That's what you're looking for. And we talked about it, clutch up those close moments. It's been a problem for them all year long. They finally did it yesterday. They didn't really have that there. That one wasn't close.
Yeah, can they get them to the post-match?
That's the point.
For that
to
come into play. On the other side of it, Joe, what were your thoughts?
Remove raid hardpoint. Play to your strength and speed on checkmate and garrison. Garrison gets vetoed. They get Moscow. They're 4-0 on that. Now 5-0. They'll take that. And, well, we have checkmate map 4 if it comes down to it. Keep up with the strong defensive rounds and control. They're 22-3 in control defensive rounds. They lead the CDL. And well, Cellium, I'll tell you what, this guy can shut down Cayman Insight. He might be the MVP throughout stage two right now. I mean, you look at those stats, the guy, I gotta show MC some love, man.
No, it's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. And it feels like sometimes the biggest threat to this team is if, an ego gets out of control or selfishness or money, or it's like some sort of internal conflict. But, you know, when we talk to Crowder, it's just like, I don't know, man. It just seems like kids that love playing video games. And they're having a good time.
The only conflict they might have is what Zellium put McDonald's in S tier, which that might have caused a fight on one of my old teams, but hey, that's about it.
But I'll tell you what, I can throw back some of those triple cheeseburgers, Joe. Let me tell you.
Triple, huh?
Triple, yeah. Double's not enough. I need three delicious beef patties in my mouth.
All right, well, we're getting a raid search and destroy. This is an interesting one. It's a very good map for Toronto Ultra, 5-1, and they beat FaZe here. The only loss for Atlanta FaZe on this map is to the Ultra. We heard the listening, maybe, you know, Insolent Energy was there. It kind of felt like they knew that map was over. They have to get on the board. They got to build some momentum. This needs to be the map to do it.
Well, let's stick with Ultra. Off the break, right towards A we go. Just taking a look at the break on defense. What, you've got one holding Kitchen and Arcitys. The rest, it's a B call. So Ultra should be able to get this down quickly. Now all going to be on the retake. The one watching mid-map crosses Insight.
All that timing.
It looks like he gave it up and backed up. Yeah.
Well, Kleenex okay. is watching it, and then aBeZy just comes on. And usually it's aBeZy and Simp inside a courtyard to retake that. aBeZy, though, just doing it by himself, able to find the third, looking for the ace. If I'm him, I'm saying give it to me. He's looking for Cammy. He's going to go for the challenge up top. And oh,
what?
Baby, aBeZy.
Well, you got them in the map
to undo it all.
Then aBeZy just came in, 4'11" drop kick to the dome. Ace to start us off. That looks far too easy.
He's got some flexibility. 4'11", he could hit you in the head. That's some flexibility.
Hey, he might need a trampoline.
We're adding factors in there, but I mean, this is just all him. He gets some great timing on the two players low. He's by himself, but he just reads the map. Insight's got no shot. And like I said, he wanted the ace. And there's that smile.
Okay. Well, you said they need to come out and rebound from the map one. That just can't be the easiest round one then to answer back. But you got to muster something up here if you're Ultra. Now, the best attacking team in SND in the game. We'll get to the attack. Simp opens it up, the nade, but not much of a first blood as Insight does take out aBeZy. And that's a big kill getting him off the map.
Yeah, it must have been like I think they naded front door Kitchen. I think there was like a... They grouped it together. Multiple nades landed front door. I mean, teams, listen, we talked kind of joked about it, but those Semtexes, they go fast and they go far. And people are starting to get very nerdy with them. Simp, though, he's going to get caught. He's watching that pinch. Cammy going to make this a 3v2. I'm not being planted yet. And it looks like Arcitys and Cellium, maybe they want to try to isolate inside. It looks like that's going to be the play. But here comes the push to the middle of the map. And there we go,
there
Toronto.
Go.
This is what they did, though. It was all about mid pressure. On their defensive rounds, when they beat Atlanta FaZe last time, they do it again here.
Yeah, well, that was the one where they, like, went, when we thought FaZe was, like, invincible in search, and Ultra went up 4-0 and ended up taking it. They showed they can do it. Nice rebound there. After the map won, Emmy and Vance lead the way with two kills. So what do you do? I mean, if you're looking at this and you're the coach of Ultra or the players, and you know how good FaZe are at attacking... Is there any specific prep you can do? Just in general, on defense to slow them down?
Listen, you'll take an A plan. I take plans all day if I'm a team. It's just you have to execute after that. You take a 4v4, how could you not? They're going to give you the plan, you take it. It's just you can't let aBeZy run down your throat and kill all of you. Yeah. You know, this time they Vance is able to get away, aBeZy almost catches him. But now you have the numbers, and okay, aBeZy just runs at him, and that's what you can't allow happen. They're right there.
What, just getting smoked?
Yeah.
So your advice is don't get smoked.
And this is what I mean, though, because what you're forcing FaZe to do if you win a round like this is to make adjustments. You have to make them uncomfortable. But they just stacked B. They retook A in two defensive rounds in a row. They're going to keep doing that. They will give it to them until it works.
Well, I'm more meant actually on the other side, which I should have waited for next round. Like FaZe's attack is so good compared to every other team. Like, it's not even close. Like, their attack stats are absurd in search. Like, is there anything, like, what do you do to slow that down? I guess I should have waited another round.
Well, yeah, I mean, they had a really good retake in their first defensive round. And when you're winning those rounds, FaZe is more than likely going to try and do something else. And maybe that's the case. His bomb is kind of slowed towards Zig right now. Looks like there's going to be a two-man push. This might be a mid-take from FaZe.
Or I love aBeZy's challenging.
Yeah, confidence.
Craig, yeah. Wait.
It's a heat check.
It certainly is.
Well, look at his timing, though. We're past him. I think Cammy's watching the cross, though. Cammy watched the cross. That forces Bans to turn around. Cammy was watching the cross from inside a kitchen. He played the info. Now it's all down to Cell in a 1v4.
Nice play there from Vance. Cell will drop, and Crowder is going to be having a talk with aBeZy later.
Maybe. I don't know.
Hey,
maybe.
Hey, Tyler, why are we challenging a Craig across raid? Well, yeah, Nace in round one.
Yeah, that's what I would say if I was in. Yeah, 100%. Yeah.
All right.
But they're doing what they need to do, right? You're forcing Atlanta FaZe to do something a little different on offense now. They're staying in this game. Now what can they do on attack?
If you get this free plant again, like, how can you just get a little bit better position? Well, first blood helps massively. Nice job. Arcitys, though, brings it to a 3v3. A little stun check to make sure they're not on A. It's that information. So they're thinking B, I think, based off of that stun, but bomb is still lurking mid-map in Bance's hands.
And this is the same defense Atlanta FaZe is throwing. Three up B, one hole in middle. Ultra, though, a little bit different. They just take mid-map away, so they're able to force this 3v3, but now we're into this retake. It really feels like Atlanta FaZe does not want the B bomb site to go down. They're holding laundry. They're making sure they have ring control round and round again. We're into another 3v3. Can Ultra win one? You win one, you force them to adjust on defense. Look at number 7 inside. He's lurked around. He's lurked around. Can he find the first call on Cell? He can.
Just feels like eventually, if you're going to get free plants and equal scenarios, eventually you're going to win a round. You would think.
You would think.
It is. Insight. Making the play. Simp now. By himself. 1v3. Down to a 1v2. And he will get drop. Ultra. There they go. Up 3-2. Nice hold in the post plant position. And yeah, they've been in such good spots on offense this time. They get it done.
Hey, Insight with a little bit different. Cellium's looking over towards Zig. He doesn't see it these days, so he probably just thinks it's a three-man setup over towards bedroom. But Insight with nice timing. He gets... got down to 1 HP there. There we go. 2 rounds in a row now. Again, you're forcing FaZe to have to make some adjustments. Cellium 0-3. See what they do on this attack round.
And look at this. Everybody.
Did these guys have an agreement?
Just like, let's just practice A retakes. Get it down, and then we'll take turns, just trying to retake.
Yeah,
that's what
time and
looks
time
like.
Again. Bomb being planted. Here we go. We're doing the dance again.
And 3 back up towards apartment side. 1 holding this water cut, and aBeZy can't quite get out. So nice trade there from Cammy to at least keep it all square. But you're down to 24 seconds right now. Great shots again from Insight. The shot has been on point. Bance lurking through the water. Now just down to Simp. 16 seconds to go. They stack. I thought maybe they line up. But Insight, big gunfight win after big gunfight win. 4-2 Ultra.
I don't even know if that was... Did Cell even shoot? I think that might just be a wall bang. He might have just wall banged him there.
I'd have to see.
Okay, see, spots it. Yeah, it's a wall bang there. That's all. Cell just over shoulders there. He over shoulders, he gets peaked, and then, you know, Bance is just swimming. He's doing a lap, and you don't expect that. A bit of an off angle there. Simp almost lines him up. If he's able to stay alive, he probably would have won it. There was only, what, like 12 seconds left.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he was. I thought he was just going to get the first and back down, but he's probably thinking he's on bomb. He might have hopped it early. Yeah. I got it. Yeah, mm-hmm. I got to put it down, but put him down. And Cell, who had a terrific. App number one, 0-4 through 6 rounds here in the search. aBeZy right at you. That's going to be bombed down. Another first blood for aBeZy, but they do get the insta trade. aBeZy just wants another ace. He's already had one. Going for another. A little weak, though, and Kleenex gets the kill. So 2v2. Nice win again. Kleenex and aBeZy just trading blows. Cellium pinned. No kills. Still as Ultra. Another round up 5-2.
All right, that is one where Crotter, I think, you get a little bit angry.
Yeah,
I think if you're aBeZy here, you do that. You just gotta wait. Yeah, there's no, I mean, I think you have your teammates watching over you, right? Just play your life in this position, and then you see what the re-challenge from a player. I think it was maybe Arcitys, but Ultra, they wanted the challenge on raid. Well, Atlanta FaZe did, and Ultra taking it to him.
Yeah, I mean, considering the first round was that aBeZy ace, since then, 5-1 in the scoreline for Ultra. And it's great first blood. I think one thing that stood out to me, too, as a team kill comes in, and this map's about to be over.
Okay.
Ants, who we saw, you know, he was getting first blooded on this map, like, struggling. Hasn't been the case here. He's been staying alive, playing his life. aBeZy's getting shot from every which way, and Ultra take it to him. Now we've got ourselves this series, a big search victory for Ultra. Cammy, the final shot's through.
In that right there is just like, you know, they don't want to play checkmate search. So what do? They veto checkmate, Atlanta FaZe does. That leaves Raid open. And I think when Toronto see Raid open, you're at 5-1, your eyes probably light up. Like, let's do it. Let's do this dance. And Atlanta FaZe just wanted to take it to him. Say, we're very confident in this map. But Cell, I'm going to curse them a little bit. 0-6, the donut is there.
Oof.
Nice adjustments from Ultra.
Not even like damage. He had 387. Like, he just wasn't having a fun match.
That's what they needed, though, right? They needed momentum, right? Some confidence with the belt. Like, we can do this. We can fight 100%. Fire with fire with these guys.
Did you notice something, too, Joe? When it showed the FaZe cams, the only player left was aBeZy because he didn't want to step away. His Crowder is going to slap him. So he stayed there. He was scared.
No, Chris is in California, there in Atlanta.
That'd be a far slap. Let's look at our U.S. Army tactical play. It's going to be round 6, and inside, he had a couple rounds back-to-back where he was just winning gunfight after gunfight. We're going to check it out again. Impressive.
Well, this is that retake. You know, this is one of the rounds where it really gets Atlanta FaZe. They have to try and switch things up on offense, and it's inside with that kill on the Cellium. Cellium is shouldering. He's shouldering, and while he gets caught, the wall bang is in, and then he's able to help his teammates put some bullets in, and they needed this round big time. Simp almost lines all three up, but Insight is there for the trade and gets the defuse.
There's been, I mean, for FaZe, they were so, it looked perfect in search, so great. I mean, now you have the loss here. You know, you lose a couple of searches over the stretch of stage 2. Do you think there is something to...
It's an express.
Is it really just the express? I was wondering, the teams, do you think maybe catching up a tiny bit or just... You know, them trying some different maps.
They typically veto checkmate, so it would come down to them having to get better at raid or them getting better at express.
True. Well, it is a loss there. Ultra, impressive win. Control, up next.
The Call of Duty League is brought to you by GameFuel. Use code CDL2021 for a special discount on GameFuel.com. Tournament audio and team listenings are powered by Astro Gaming, the official headset and mix amp of the Call of Duty League. The Call of Duty League is presented by Zenny, the official eyewear for the CDL. Armor your eyes with Zenny Blocks blue light protection glasses by visiting zenny.com/gaming.
Hello, thanks for watching. If you want more rewards, be sure to click on the rewards button right next to the diamond icon. Be sure to subscribe for more CDL content.
Well, FaZe haven't suffered a ton of losses in search and destroy. Now they got to look to rebound, get locked in. At times last year, the immaturity shone through. They didn't step up to the plate at major tournaments when needed. This is when they got a rebound.
Yeah, I mean, you refocused a little bit, but it's all about the Atlanta FaZe, their hot start. You look at that. Game one and game two, they rank one in those categories. I mean, as we said, they're basically first in about everything, but that's what they've focused on. You go up 2-0 in that series, and it's just like demoralizing. That's why Ultra needed that. You kind of heard it in the listening. But that was a big, big time map for them.
No, it absolutely was. I mean, they need to kind of shut down the keys to victory they have for FaZe or their success statistically. You saw they were able to do it there. But if you check out the Scuff Gaming Twitter right now, there's a giveaway going down. Joe, how much do you love your Scuff?
I love it a lot. A lot. Like not as much as you a lot, but like I'm always making sure I take good care of it.
Yeah, I can't reach one. I'll be honest with you. Somewhere. But all right, we're getting ready now to get into the control. We move forward in this series. Ultra, got to be feeling good. Map one, you know, it's a story of, like, rebounds. You know, we're talking last series about that moment that happened in the control, and if you're Røkkr, if you could answer, they did. You get smoked in the map one if you're Ultra. You have to get back into it in the search and destroy and refocus. They do. So first step done, the rebound's in. They tie up the series. Now can you keep that going?
Yeah, that's the big thing. Can you keep this going? And Ray Control, I mean, 4-1 for Atlanta FaZe. And again, they are the best defensive team, 22-3. And Ultra get one on the board. Toronto Ultra, they have a lot of reps here. They've played this map 10 times. Wow. 10 times, 4-6. So you know that they're probably getting better. What do you learn from? So we'll see if they can clutch this one on out.
I just saw a stat actually from Tyler, too, that map one was FaZe's largest hardpoint victory of the season at plus 136.
Huh. Okay.
Not that it matters now. I just didn't know that was their biggest all year. Well, three do go down early here for Ultra. So what did we see in the last series here? It was like great opening breaks, A done within the first 30 seconds basically every time. It doesn't look like that's going to be the case here with a defensive start from FaZe.
Yeah, Cellium opens things up with more kills than he had throughout that map, too.
Nah, he didn't have to go
Ultra
there, Joe.
Trying to, I know. Sorry, that's my bad. But Ultra get aggressive up the middle. The pinch is in, though, from Arcitys. Now they're forcing him towards B.
And this might be why their defense is so good. Already up 5 lives. Only 45 seconds remaining. Simp, who's at 4-0, is just eating grenades for breakfast. And he's still... No.
Oh, that's awful, Ed.
No. I thought for sure after the nades hit, Simp was dead to rights, but then he comes away with it with 2 kills up to 6-0. Cell hasn't died either. He just reversed his stats.
Yeah, streak.
From 0-6 to 6-0, streaks in. 10 life advantage.
When is the last time we saw this? Just a holding where they don't even get a point on raid. There's still
not
some
often.
Time to work with. But Atlanta FaZe, this has been just about perfect. Just about perfect for them. You still have who's at Cellium, aBeZy here to stop them on A. Cammy's trying to work the middle of the map. He might have to go to B, but he's gonna group up with his teammates. They finally get the players off the zone. But if you're FaZe, do you try to retake this? Maybe try to end the round quickly. There's only 9 lives.
Yeah, with the advantage in lives, you can kind of do whatever you want. They get them off the point. Time continues to dwindle. They want to take this over to the other side. There's a 1-on-1 that's going to get well, but it's a 2-on-1. I take it back. In through kitchen comes Cellium. FaZe take one of the more dominant control rounds you're going to see.
Yes, it was. That's really it. I mean, that was just from start to finish.
It started the break was clean, and they got in position, and it was just 3 down, 4 down, 3 down, 4 down.
Yeah, and they got in those spawn traps. Can never get out of it.
What was Kleenex shooting there? Like, how did he even get 2 kills?
I didn't think he was there. I have no clue. But he does. And he gets the artillery. They're up 1-0. Cellium, what a bounce back round for him. 11-2.
Yeah. What's that salt in slow-mo? Is it that looked worse than I thought it was in regular speed. Everybody towards A for Ultra.
Look at this. B for FaZe.
Yeah, B for FaZe.
And they at least get a take. It looks like they're going to at least find one for right now. You'll take that. But we know how this works. See, if this doesn't work out too well, they spend too much time here. Ultra could put them in a position where they don't have enough time to win the round. And while they find all the kills, now he's just going to force FaZe to move on over. Cellium was still lurking, and there's going to be two players on A already.
And it looks like if you're ultra about even in lives, already second bit done, just going to give this up, try to get set up, get as much map control as possible. Number six and Bance moving all the way towards back garage. And these kills in transition are huge if you're ultra. Unfortunately, they go one for two, which will allow FaZe to start to layer the map a bit.
Well, Arcitys knows someone's probably in this position. But to help a Simp, middle of the map, the next is going to find a kill. Vance is there, though. He's going to find one, and he's just wasting time. He knows someone else is hunting him, but Simp just gives him the elbow.
Yeah, he just guessed wrong. Like, you see the patience to clear. Just he looks left. Vance is right. Doesn't matter that Simp runs through the glass. He's just going to take the gunfight. 10-3 start from Simp now. At this water cut, I was going to say Bance in a good position to at least delay this, but he gets dropped. The ping is in. The positions are known. That's why you see Simp snapping right to the window. Off the back of the ping, they get on to B, and Simp seems invulnerable as he's just, he ate those two nades, just taking shots on the cross somehow, getting through. aBeZy mantles in and drops, but there, the streak will be used. Hey, second bit of progress done at B.
Yeah, they're very close as well. Cammy's going to fly out. Inside is there. They use that streak. They get to that point. Bance still holds on. It only needs a little bit more. Bance with those two kills. aBeZy's trying to fly into this position. Is he going to get it done? He does. I think one player was flying out of money window. There we go. Atlanta FaZe. They go to B off the rip. They get map control. They use the streak. They're able to get control in. I mean, 2-0 very fast.
Yeah, and I think, yeah, you get A quick, which, you know, we see quite often, but that, I don't know, when you're trying to kind of move from A to B, it usually takes a good bit of time. You have to fight through a couple waves, but I think they ended up getting two or three kills pretty quickly. Just their movement across the map a little bit too easy, so that pressure to B happened so fast. Ultra never really recovered. Is there's a shooting gallery here at mid. Let's just bring it to the pistol. Okay, why not? 12-4 from Simp. Triple positive. I mean, him and Cell right now are what, 28-9 or something?
I mean, they just haven't even been able to get to A. They've just been trapped. They're trapped again. Look at Arcitys's position. They're spawning them, Jim. He's got the crossfire set up. Cammy knows there's probably someone back here. There's the reposition, but Arcitys takes down two.
I'll tell you what, I mean, the search win was impressive, but these two respawns, I don't know the best adjective or best way to describe them, but it's not competitive. Like,
what? And I think it just shows you, like, how close, like, you know, their matches, maps were with OpTic. Like, they're a good team at these maps, right? Like, it's not like they're not on rated control, raid hardpoint, or it's just, FaZe is that good right now. I wish I could give you more, but that's really
it. I know. It's like difficult to commentate them sometimes when it's like this. They're just running through them.
I mean, this was
like
a problem in their match. They outslayed by 57 kills in the last 3-0.
Joe, I think it might be more than that. Because they're going to get another respawn to add on to the tally.
Well, 12 seconds left. Kleenex is here. It is just, it's insane. You're going to get to position, but it's the same thing. You finally get to A, but you have 8 lives left. You have 8 lives left.
Well, they're trying to do their best to extend this clock and just finish A, but yeah, we've seen some miracle rounds. We just saw one. You can be down in lives huge and get one big wave of kills and get onto the point. They'll
hit
the time.
If there's 1 point left, I don't know. They have to peel layer by layer back. There's
nice
a start.
Play.
Here we go.
Yeah, that's two down. It's not impossible. It is not impossible. It takes a moment. Look how fast it's going. Everybody stacked to the point. Second bit done. Here comes the push through. Two are going to drop. No respawns remaining. There, everybody falls, and the retake comes in. But that is exactly what I was talking about. Like, it takes one moment, and that was almost done. But the retake, simply too strong. They get back onto it. Now the only guy left is Insight, and he will fall. FaZe take the control in convincing fashion. They'll go up 2-1.
I mean, just that round one, like the dominance, that's the, one of the better defensive rounds we've, it might be the best defensive round we've seen in a long time, in a very long time. They do it again there in round three, and well, that's a rebound, Matt. Maybe, I mean, a little pissed off. Cellium with a great start, with a great rebound, and back in control.
Yeah, back in control, and we'll head to another hard point. Or we'll see if Ultra can improve maybe upon, you know, what went wrong in that first map, but clinical in the respawn so far is FaZe. And I mean, that's what's frightening. That's their sixth control 3-0 this season, which is the most in the league. But it's rare that you have a team that is considered the best search team and best respawn team. It just doesn't really happen. I mean, if you think of like the Optic Dynasty or Complexity Dynasty, I'm not saying they're there yet. They're not, obviously, but usually it was the respawns that carried the load, and they were good in search. This team, yeah, they're good at it all.
But Ultra, I mean, hey, they win that map too. Now we get to their hard point. That's the good thing for them. You get to the map four. This is their hard point pick now. So this is our map. We got to bring it.
Yeah, no, it's your pick. You have to come in locked in, brush off that map one, and bounce back with a vengeance. You know, you get into a search, you've got a shot to take this series and shock the world. Can you do it? Ultra, the battle continues on after this break.
The Call of Duty League is presented by T-Mobile, now America's largest and fastest 5G network. Set your sights on the competition with T-Mobile, the leader in 5G.
In 2020, our fans and teams wanted to see top players recognized throughout the course of a CDL season. Well, you asked, and we listened. In Major One weekend, we crowned Simp the player of the stage. This championship Sunday, we'll be crowning our second player of the stage, powered by Astro Gaming. All of your favorite CDL casters and analysts will be putting their heads together to determine the player who exhibited the skill, sportsmanship, and consistency throughout this stage in order to win this title, and we'll be announcing it after the final match. So, you know, just looking to give props and praise where it is due. We'll see who it's going to be this time through stage two. Or if Simp can go back to back, we'll see. But let's look at our maps and modes and where we stand now. FaZe up 2-1. The respawn's convincing, but a great search win there from Ultra. It's just, can they get to that map? Can they get to Miami? They do, they got a shot.
Well, and I think a lot of teams outside of this match as well are also watching this, because Checkmate has become a really popular hardpoint map, and Atlanta FaZe, they're 1-2 on this map. aBeZy, a great game for him, Cellium as well. I mean, it was the dominant performance in that Moscow hardpoint. But you know, Atlanta FaZe, they opt in for the raid veto, so Toronto, they pick Checkmate where they're 3-3. But as I said, you know, a lot of teams are just sort of seeing what can we, if there's any openings, where is it for Atlanta FaZe?
Yeah, I kind of mentioned the map pull earlier. It gives them a little bit of freedom, but in a way I was wrong. I mean, they do have the widest map pull, I think anyone would argue. But if this is a weakness, then something they're trying to fix. And I think that's what they're working on. I think when you and I talked about that, into stage one, right? Where they first played this and they had already locked up first place. Just trying to work and get better at it.
Well, and again, they can still play Raid Hardpoint if they have to. I think this is just a respect pick from Toronto Ultra on how well they looked at it. And sure. Atlanta FaZe with Checkmate, you're going to get more engagements on this map. You're going to take those gunfights. And the first two respawns, you want that all day.
Their opening breaks have been so good. In the first two respawns, just putting Ultra on the back foot nearly instantly. Can you do a bit better here if you're Ultra? Just giving you a chance in the early going. And this tough part is you're starting on the strong side as well. aBeZy storms through it too. Cellium eats a nade to the face and kind of trades back and forth inside the plane.
Yeah, Sammy does a great job staying alive. Arcitys there for the trade. It's about staying alive for now if you're Atlanta FaZe. Make sure you have those spawns for the second L, but you don't want to give up too much time. Now, this is the strong side. So they're going to try and fight back. aBeZy does spawn out. So aBeZy spawns out, and that's two dead. It's going to be a race.
You see
at the top side of the map, Cammy's going. Cammy is going. Kleenex with a kill, and there we go. That should be the spawn flipped for the second hill. A great job by Toronto Ultra. They're getting the time as well.
And that's the better opening I wanted to see. This is fantastic. What a flip it was. Now that strong side start, not as much of an issue. You won't go into that massive hole early in the game. You'll give up these final couple of seconds, get posted up, set up. I know FaZe liked the break, but you got to put yourself in positions the best you can here if you're Ultra.
We'll see now. Where does the push start from? They're trying to go all the way towards that lower side of the map. Insight and Bands are ready for it, though. Here comes Simp, the last player alive. He's at least able to get one off. Cellium gets a kill across the map. They get him off the hill. That will allow them to at least work up the map, but Cammy is there trying to get those cutoffs, does just that.
And what you've watched from FaZe on this particular map, you mentioned the 1-2 record. Has there been, I guess, anywhere they've
struggled?
I can't
tell you last time I saw it. I have no idea. Yeah,
sure. I was trying to think of it too, like where they were. Where
I don't remember the last time we casted them on this.
Yeah, right. Or we might have expected based on the side start for FaZe to have this lead. They do not. It is all Ultra, 75-6 now. Just 6 points earned from FaZe through two hard points. Ultra, they have done what they needed to do early. But a lot of times on this map where it starts to shift is in these upcoming hard points. Now FaZe's chance to kind of swing this lead.
It's just the slaying right now. That's really the key difference for me. We saw it in 1-3. Yeah. It was very one-sided. But look at the top right. You have Bans, who's +4. Insight's positive. Kleenex is right around even. Cammy's +5. And they're just taking it to them. They are running away with this momentum. Atlanta FaZe trying to fight back. But every little second counts for Toronto Ultra.
That's what you needed. You were outslaved by 19 in map 1, 31 in map 3. You had to bring it in that regard, and they're doing it right now. FaZe getting smoked. They've got 6 points on the board. Let's go to an Astro listening with FaZe.
I'm going to go.
I'm in wood,
I'm in wood.
I'm in wood.
I have top. I full flashed you.
I have top plane. I'm looking under plane. I have left. He's killing me from him, actually.
I'm trying to help you, Chris. One shot top plane. Vance. He's going next.
Under plane. He's hitting you. I'm dead. Came, he's our steps. Ask Keith.
Well, I think when we went into the listening, they were down 80 or 90. They brought it back, Joe. What'd you like from the calls?
I mean, just, you know, we're still missing one. I think it was Simp, right? We're missing one. Don't allow Bands, I think it was, who snuck all the way towards the back to make a play. They didn't allow that. They get the flip. They were down 80. They get this fifth hill. And the slaying has really turned around for Atlanta FaZe. But it's just, hey, let's push forward. We're going to flip them. But there may be one more. They are on top of who's alive right now for Toronto Ultra. And after all is said and done, as good as a start as it was for Ultra, it is a tied game after this first rotation.
Yeah, and, you know, you're getting smoked and bodied early in it. And they didn't seem frustrated either, which, I mean, they know how they had that comeback ability, obviously. But I don't know. Just on point for the most part. Now, this is where they need to be better. Last time through, they got flipped out. Didn't really do anything in the second hard, but what, 6 points through the first three hard points. This first half of it is where we'll see if they can improve. A little 360 from Simp, spinning in circles, putting Bants.
I think they thought they had the spawns, but there was a bit of a split there. And then Cammy spawns behind them, so they'll at least get this time, which is a nice 30 seconds. They have some pressure here from Clean Ice Top Wayne. He's able to find that. Bants is all the way topside, but look, Arcitys is picking that up, making sure a pinch doesn't happen, at least not for free. He's going to be aware of it. Bants just going to back on through. While that's happening, you have Cellium and Simp trying to get aggressive down low. aBeZy now on a five spree. Linux does find Cell. This has to be it for Ultra. Can they execute on this second hill?
Well, that's twice. They've done a great job breaking through. And maybe a misplay from FaZe, but...
Artillery.
Good stuff from Ultra. Seven in a row, eight in a row, streaks all over the place. Is aBeZy. I mean, his stats throughout, what, map one was good, two, good. I don't even remember the control stats, but this one, fantastic again at 25 and 18. We'll see when the streaks do come into play, but FaZe do break back into it despite losing those spawns midway through first. And they're winning the big gunfights.
I mean, that's just all aBeZy. I mean, he really does. He makes the plays. He breaks on through. Now he has the streaks. That was the chance for Ultra to take their lead, keep it around 40 to 50, put the pressure on Atlanta FaZe. But now that script, it's flipped. You're going to have a 40-point lead for Atlanta FaZe. And, you know, when you know you have the third and the fourth hill coming up, you can just sort of pick away at it. You get 10 seconds here, 10 seconds there. Then you look up and it's all right, FaZe is at 225. That pressure starts to build up for Toronto Ultra. Can they hold on? We've seen some really good holds on this third hill, getting those players spawning top right, but FaZe, they're going to find two kills. Simp now on a four spree, make it number five as they break out.
And just winning fights at range with that AK-74U in hand. Up comes Arcitys, but Insight, Kleenex, chained together kills. Back into the point kill, Ultra down around 30 as aBeZy is lurking. And we'll see if FaZe can get through again. aBeZy is just on one, 29 and 20. Looking for number 30. There it is.
But again, number 30 still has his streaks too. You know, I guess knowing streaks, you probably don't want to lose spawns for the fifth hill because, again, we're on checkmate. Streaks aren't the you know, they don't have the most impact here. They need something. They can have that to get them off the point. Ultra, though, fighting on back. They're getting some good time here. Simp, though, just lurking, just waiting for his opportunity to pounce.
Here comes the streak. Missile in. Does it find a home? Its home might be Bants. Bants blown to bits. Three down for Ultra. The push through coming, but they do spawn top left still. But they got him pinned back there if they win the fights. aBeZy trying to rally over to get some help. But Kleenex goes huge off a spawn. Kleenex goes massive. Four down for FaZe. Ultra wipe him off the board after the streak. They get back into the hard point for time. A chance to rally this into fifth and take a lead.
Yeah, well, Insight stays alive inside of plane. He's up to 24 and 15, and he backs up to the stairs and help. He knew that the push was coming through topside, so he wanted to get his teammates out of that trap. They hold on to the left side. We're about to have a tie game, and all the kills coming in. Look at that. That's 10 kills in a row for Ultra. You still have the artillery, though. On the face side, things have slowed down. aBeZy 31, everyone else at 16. But they're not even close to the hill right now. Bants and Insight shutting it down.
We'll see if Simps 2 can be the difference. That's the third then with Arcitys.
You have that streak.
Several players coming off a spawn. They're going to call the streak in here. aBeZy puts it down. And FaZe get ready to surge on forward. It does connect with one. Insight's going to drop. Will it be the opener? That might be all four down. Kleenex will be the last man up for a moment to take the fight, and he will drop. One spawns in the back. We'll see if they pick that up. The rest spawning out.
They have to be aware of it. Do they know where Insight is? Do they know where Insight is?
Yep, they
yep,
sure do.
Yep, he sure does. Cellium stays alive. He's on the point. So at least break that. Okay, but they broke with 20 seconds left, and because Ultra had such a good third and fourth hill, they're up to 215 points. Now FaZe, they're going to have to break through the play, but Cellium on another spree.
Lead.
The last Arcitys to get in here.
Leads back for FaZe. We'll see if Cellium can get those streaks, or if they'll matter. One more kill to get the artillery. Ace will continue to lurk below plane. Pushing all the way through is going to be Simp. Trying to get aggressive on the player spawning here on the right side of the map. Cellium can't hit the snap. Not going to be any streaks in. Multiple are going to drop. aBeZy's got to make the plays inside the plane. He's got some help from Arcitys. 226, 227, a nail biter here in the map four.
He just flies. He just flies. But Bantz is here. He's flying on through. Kleenex, he's the next one up. Wall bangs are in. The good thing for Ultra, they're just trying to contest. They want to get it to the second hill. They have to get in, though. Where is the contest going to come from? It looks like number seven Insight. He might go all the way around, but he gets caught. Up top, aBeZy trying to get the spawns on the hill. It's going to be Arcitys.
Yeah, that's the problem, though.
That's it. There we go. They get all the kills. They flip it. They could win it here still.
Yeah, you have to worry about the contest, but that allows them to flip, and the flip doesn't even matter because you rally together inside a plane, and once down 90, it is FaZe with the victory. They take all three respawns, and props to Ultra. They battled them far more there on the map four. But, Joe, maybe we did get to your key to victory. Those close maps, those clutch moments. Ultra has to keep improving. There, they couldn't close it out.
That just has to be it. I mean, that's really it. That they had their opportunity. They did what they needed to do on that first rotation until that fifth hill. I mean, the momentum is all on their side. They were slaying well. They had it in their hands. And they did a good enough job to stabilize, right? When FaZe starts to take the lead, they fight right on back. They get the third hill. They get the fourth hill. They have the spawns, the streaks. Obviously, they help out a big time, at least to get Atlanta FaZe in there. But I mean, you just talk about that start. You have to take advantage of that. They did it, Atlanta FaZe. They show their composure on checkmate.
They absolutely do. And just a reminder, that is a winner's match. So FaZe will move in to top three. They'll be in the winner's final against Empire, exactly what we saw back in Major 1. And for Ultra, you still have a chance to battle on. You're not out of it yet. You can make the plays to continue on and show this newly improved roster, but FaZe just too
Look
tough here.
Look at aBeZy, 35 and 30, almost 70 engagements, 6,400 damage.
6,400. Look at it compared to everyone else. Like even on the superstars on his team. Like aBeZy, dude, the map one, he dropped the bomb. Search, I know they lost. He had that crazy ace and some ego chows, but he was feeling the heat.
He's almost got 25 more engagements than every single one of his teammates. The guy was flying.
Yeah, his left stick is broken. Just holding forward.
Oh, there you can see Kleenex Lou. I have a lot of frustration there. I mean, they knew it. That was the map. It's one of those maps we talked about. You know, previous matchups with Atlanta FaZe, it was Radar Point. Just a lot of those close timings, those close maps that they need to close out on. They get this to a map five. This gets interesting, but it doesn't happen.
Yeah, no, it absolutely does. It absolutely does. But our scuff play of the game, let's check it out. It's going to be the closing moments. It's tied. Well, like 226, 226 at one point. You don't know who's going to come out of it. The pressure on Ultra to battle back in. We'll start from here.
Yeah, so I just want to see this. I think maybe Insight oversteps here a little bit. So you have everybody spawn up. You know, time's still going back and forth. Kleenex, he does not need to challenge that at all, right? Kleenex, all you have to do is contest. You need to get it to the second hill. Him dying, it forces his teammates to freak out. Insight then moves up, he gets caught. Now his teammates have to contest this. When they try and set up a contest or a pinch, they all get caught coming off a spawn. All Kleenex needs to do in those closing moments is contest. Wait for his teammates. They had to get it to the second hill. They had the time, but FaZe, they catch him off guard. He's going to be pissed about that play when he goes and watches
and
it back.
Yeah, might explain kind of his face right now, maybe just frustrated. There's a lot of pressure on that first guy up, right? Like the point man, when your teammates are coming off
but
a spawn.
But those are
the
situations
spawn, like,
that we're wondering what is going on with Toronto, what's happening, and that is a clear showing of it right there.
Absolutely. Good breakdown, Joe. But here's a reminder of how Major Tournament 2 is going thus far, where the bracket remains. FaZe and Empire on the top side. Our two losers matches coming up next. You've got OpTic Surge, Subliners, Thieves. We still got two games, Joe.
We do. Some great COD as well. I mean, Seattle and OpTic are going to be a close one. New York, Thieves, that could be as well. We had no idea about that new LA Thieves team. New York didn't have the best showing yesterday. You know they want to bounce back.
Yeah, no, this should be a wild one. Who knows who's going to win it? That's been why we've been so excited for this particular tournament, just due to some of the results from Stage 2, how tight it was. When you talk about the groups, it feels like in the middle of the pack, just about anyone can beat anyone on any given day. And that's what makes this so fun. But we still have what? Today with the two matches, Saturday and Sunday to round out this tournament. We've got a ton more majors, champs. We got a lot to do this year. You know, there's a ton of COD to come.
There's a lot of COD. If it's anything like this, I'm all in, baby. I'm all in. Keep giving it to me.
Absolutely. It's a pleasure and a blast to commentate Call of Duty at this level and see what these players are capable of. But FaZe will move on. Empire will move on. I think those were probably as close as you could get to, I don't know, locks to get to that point. I think that'd be the pick for a lot of people, even though I took Røkkr in that series. They could have won it too, Joe. Let me know.
I took New York. Oh, so, yeah, I messed that one up.
I don't know why I took Røkkr. I just had a feeling.
Well.
I was looking at the brackets that all of the talent were talking about. Like, no one's got any points in the prediction stuff. Like, no one's got anything. It's just been insane. I'm sure you at home are struggling as well, but aBeZy had himself a series. He is a talent, the likes of which we rarely ever see. A monster on the map. We've got him with Jess after this break.
Back for another Game Fuel Victory Spotlight. This time we've got Too Easy for aBeZy with us. Now, that was a great series. That second hard point is what I really want to touch on first. I mean, you pulled it off, but started off a little slow there. What did it do to your mentality to go down by about 100 points nearly instantly there?
We knew that they were good off the rip of the game at P1 and P2. I mean, they went up a lot against their last match against I forgot who it was against, but they went up a lot of points, and we just knew that we could bring it back on the P3, P4, and P5 rotations. So, and that's what we did. So, you know, we brought it back and we start frying.
And hey, what happens during the actual round doesn't really matter. It's the scoreline that counts, and you certainly got that. So I do want to touch on the S&D as well. I mean, you and Simp, the Tiny Terrors, you're kind of, you've been known for your S&D play. So losing 6-2 to Toronto on that S&D, is that anything that you're maybe concerned about?
Not really. I mean, we kind of just played that S&D really poorly. I was playing a little too fast at points and was getting blooded a little bit and just not playing my life enough, so not too worried about it.
Well, that's great to hear that you kind of know what you did wrong. You know what you can do better for next time, and that's really all that counts. Well, aBeZy, thank you so much. Congrats on the win. Those watching at home, we have two more matches. You do not want to miss this next one. OpTic Chicago versus Seattle Surge. We'll be right back. Can't stop the kid. Check the scoreboard, I'm running up stats. Numbers don't lie, that's facts. They can't stop it. They can't stop the kids. They can't stop it. They can't stop the kid. Say the numbers, I'm running it up. I got penny bands, I'm thumbing it. Yeah. Do what you can, you can try. You can't stop it. OC dub, way up, like a rocket. Acting up, acting out, way out of pocket. For the grind, for the hustle, I can't knock it. Do what it take, do what you do, you can try. I've been up, I've been stuck up in the sky. Only at the top, I can't lie. Haters watch it, throw the piece, tell them bye. I got things to do, I got fans to get. Competition up in smoke, ooh, cannabis. Ask me why I'm a top 10 candidate. I'm so fly, I'm so clean, ooh, and I'm rich. They can't stop it, they can't stop the kids. They can't stop it, they can't stop the kids. Check the scoreboard, I'm running up stats. Numbers don't lie, that's facts. They can't stop it, they can't stop the kids. They can't stop it, they can't stop the kids. Check the numbers, I'm running it up. I got penny bands, I'm thumbing it, yeah. Tell them move. Get up out the way. It's ludicrous, yeah, how much I'm getting paid. 2, 4, 5, 7, 8, 10K. No mob ties for the player being made. Now how you spoke to your girl, better check her phone. And do you know what she doing when you not at home? And when she tell you she alone, but she not alone. She got a lot of options, any money more. She gon' do what she want, ain't no stopping it all. Pour the liquor in the cup, yeah, I'm topping it all. I might take your girl, take a trip to the mall.
It might just come down to Scump. Somebody has to make the play. Time's starting to dwindle. There goes Scump as well. And it will be the Ultra winning out this hard point and taking down OpTic Chicago.
Oh, boys.
What are you talking about, baby?
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to the Stage 2 Major. It is match 3 of Day 3. We've got ourselves a good old elimination game. Loser finishes off in top 8. Winner advances to hopefully find some new life in our elimination bracket. We join you with eager faces coming into this series. Of course, it's Lado and Study bringing you guys the cast to close out our last two matches. And Study, we've got some great ones.
Yeah, we got some great matches, man. Win-or-go-home situations for both these matches coming up. We're going to start with OpTic versus the Surge. OpTic not having the match they wanted to yesterday versus the Ultra, dropping 3 maps and just losing that series. And then Seattle on the opposite side, coming off of that hot win versus Florida. This is going
to
be a battle.
I really don't know what to expect, to be honest with you, man. Like, we talk about, we talk about OpTic, we talk about NYSL. There were a lot of people who thought, like, hey, maybe both of these teams could meet in the grand finals. Maybe one of them could contest a FaZe or a Dallas. You just really don't know what to expect when it comes down to the Stage 2 Major. But, folks, let's go ahead and meet one of our first two teams, starting things off with OpTic Chicago.
Bristle Mighty keeps it going.
Normal, looking fantastic.
Envoy slaying his way through. Scump from up high, the king. I'm out here doing what they thinking
is irrational. Really starting to run that score up. I'm gonna make it back, back.
I'm gonna make it back, back, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, OpTic gaming are back.
Chicago are a force to be reckoned with.
I mean, what? OpTic off of a shocking loss yesterday to the Toronto Ultra, losing that series 3-1. A number of different times where, you know, we've kind of looked back and said, hey, what's going on with OpTic right now? Is there some inconsistencies with the team? What's kind of going down right now? Study, what's kind of been your assessment of OpTic recently, and especially in that match yesterday versus the Ultra?
Yeah, in that match yesterday versus the Ultra, it was just those closing moments towards those ending of those games. They were up 5-3 in the Search and Destroy. They start individually pushing, start trying to make those plays, and they were just getting countered every time. Then they go into the control. They have a live advantage on their offense. I'm pretty sure they were up by like 6 or 7 lives. Envoy's finessing the entire time in basketball, and they're all just flooding front. Just forgetting the fundamentals. You got to keep those to be able to close out those games.
And they're going to need that coming into this series today versus a team that has looked hot, at least as of lately, getting a win yesterday, unlike OpTic. Of course, OpTic off the loss, Seattle off the win. Let's go and put our hands together for our team that sits on the other side, the Seattle Surge.
Prestinni looking dangerous.
He's just ripping. The entirety of the Guerrillas. Wow.
Oh, aggressive as always. Diamondcon head rip off.
Looking to find a few more, but Gunless absolutely rips his way through the three of them.
249, 249, Seattle won! And there's a look at your Seattle Surge. I mean, a totally different looking team in terms of just the result, right? The roster stays the same, but the team, just their performance from stage one to stage two, looking like a much different squad. I mean, what, last major study, we were casting over the team and we're unfortunately seeing them exit top 12. Now with a win here, if they can get the win over OpTic today, they guarantee themselves top 6 here at our stage 2 major. What's really been the big difference maker, you think, from stage 1 to stage 2 for this team?
Well, ever since Stage 2 has started, Seattle has been at a whole different level, especially Prestinni. The guy has found that consistency in his gameplay, and it's been showing every single match that they have played so far throughout Stage 2. But we're going to hop in with these keys to victory for Seattle. Teamwork needs to be at an all-time high. Yesterday versus the Mutineers, everything was just clicking. Every time someone dropped, it was always someone playing their life, playing it properly to make those plays. Prestinni, especially as that playmaker, he needs to be able to control his aggression versus a stack-slaying squad in OpTic, of course. But he's been doing that a lot recently. And then Gunless in those respawns, he's the X factor. He had a 1.33 versus Florida. No teammates were over a 1.0, but that's where that teamwork has been really clicking for these guys. They just need to be able to bring that overall throughout from start to finish of this series.
And it's been so great too. I know, like, you know, there was a lot of drama last year whenever it was kind of around the Seattle Surge. It was like, Sam needs some help. And really, when we talk about Stage 2 specifically, he's got it, man. Like, Prestinni and Gunless, at least from the slang side of things, I know that Loony has so many kind of intangibles, but on the other side, they've just been firing on all cylinders. We're going to take a look now at our game fuel keys to victory here for OpTic Chicago. I mean, what, study? Be more disciplined today. You called it out, right? Just a number of different situations where they should have closed out games. Being up 50-plus in that game 4 hardpoint, losing the Search and Destroy despite being up 5-3. And then really for them, the kind of the major talking point, really so far throughout Stage 2, even in Stage 1 a little bit as well, has been this Search and Destroy, right? At times they look great, at times they kind of do fall flat, but there's no question about it. Envoy is that playmaker for them. He can be in the respawns, but we know how talented this guy is in those Search and Destroys as well.
Yeah, in those Search and Destroys, especially yesterday, when they were up 5-3, he was trying to make a play, flanking both players that were trying to wrap back through Eskies, but he just got caught off guard. Insight shot him in the back. But then when it goes to that 5-5, him being the playmaker once again, he pushes towards outer bricks, but he has no support this time. So Ultra, they blind counter it. They completely just four-man hit A, and they singled him out. And then once they were able to do that, they're going to force all the players to go back to B, eventually get them to come back to A. And it was just way too late, man. Envoy needs to be that playmaker, but his team needs to be there to support him.
Now, one thing that I do want to ask you about, I know we had it on the screen for a moment, was our maps and modes. And now these two teams played, I think it was like 9 days ago. Like, they played at week 3 in our Stage 2 regular season. So they're kind of fresh off of playing against one another. In that series, it was OpTic who did take the 3-0. However, we look at that series, right? Our first three that we saw are going to be the exact same maps. In fact, which we didn't see map 2 or map 4 or map 5, but the entire map set from when these teams played a week ago is the exact same now here in our Stage 2 major. Study, really from Seattle's perspective, you just got 3-0'd over a week ago. Is it kind of crazy to see the exact same three maps just 1 week later?
I don't think it's kind of crazy because the series that they played over, like, during stage two, it was really close. Like, the hard point was, like, 250, 226. The S&D was the blowout, which was 6-2. But, and then the control went to 3-2. So they were feeling really confident. The series probably could have went either way. So they were confident enough to play the same exact maps. And we're going to start on Raid Hardpoint right off the rip.
Raid Hardpoint, here we go. And we've seen Raid a decent amount recently with this OpTic Chicago lineup. We'll be happy to grab the first 14 on the clock. And really, the one guy who's going to be on our screens quite a bit, the guy we're going to be chatting a decent amount about, is going to be Gunless. Good old Pierce has a lot of history with the players that exist on the other side, but still back and forth we go. Pretty much neck and neck HP off the rip. Player 5 happened to back up. That's formal. Wins a big fight there over on Prestinni.
Yeah, and that was huge because a lot of kills were going in favor of the Seattle Surge there. So they spawned two players from OpTic out. So eventually they were setting up a pinch, but the two players that were holding back laundry, they won those engagements to make sure they secured those spawns. And now they were eventually able to chain some more time off that P1. Now they are fully set up for P2. It's all about just trying to hold them, trying to hold that first push. And this is one thing that OpTic had a problem with yesterday. It's just slowing down that first push and trying to stack up as much time as possible. As I say, again, that three are going to drop. They're going to lose back spawns. And just like that, they flip out.
Again, man, I mean, this is, for whatever reason, this hill has just been so problematic for OpTic Chicago. Again, as you called it, they struggled on it versus Toronto Ultra, where they were struggling heavily in that week two, right, where they're losing to teams that we argued they probably shouldn't have, versus Florida, versus Minnesota. It was on this very map, and the primary talking point was their ability to not hold down over on Kitchen, as Gunless heating things up on a four spree right now. And that's the guy that you really want to see going off for this Seattle lineup, is Gunless. Puts up a 1.3 yesterday versus Florida. We know that Big P can take over series from time to time, but again, OpTic now setting up for Garage, kind of licking their wounds as they set up next to the Lambos, or rather the new vehicles now, but we'll see what they can do, because again, they just got brutalized in that last HP.
Yeah, and the only thing is that this setup is so tight. So if one of those players on OpTic, they drop nice and early, they will spawn out just because of the positioning out of Prestinni. He's canceling that water spawn, and Gunless is getting every single kill outside of Art. So you're going to see a couple players from OpTic, one spawning ring, one spawning on water. But the break is in once again from the Surge.
Another break for Seattle in our Money Hills. Crazy to see, but again, at the same time, we've seen it so many times over again. Great start coming through from Seattle. They're going to be up really, what, about 90 points once this hill comes to a close. I'm really interested to kind of hear what the comms are like from Chicago and what's going to need to be a major rebound coming into what is going to be a very fascinating next hard point over at basketball court. Let's go to our Astro listening with OpTic Chicago.
Triple back
up the rip.
Watch kitchen.
I got you.
Let me see if they don't
bang this. Cut out, kitchen. Yo, yeah, cut out, open, dude. Kitchen, dead.
Nothing laundry.
Yo, cut out. Yo, and kitchen. Could be cut out, guys.
Cut out too.
Kitchen, two kitchens. One's close right and one money.
Nothing cut out. I have a cross back.
Yo, I'm being tricked.
In front of me.
Pillar, in front of me. They're spawning water, I think.
One time.
I don't see anything water.
Let's get it. I didn't see anything water.
I'm pushing out ring. Two water.
I'm helping you hold.
I'm coming to ring the map.
I think Tekken.
One can be zig.
I'm ring.
He's gonna be zigging water.
Splash water for sure.
I'm new, Preston.
Yo, top part weak.
Preston, there's one new. Preston,
top part Danny weak.
One was water, guys.
Don't see damage.
Top part weak.
Flash.
I swung kitchen.
E5.
Yo, same water stairs. Top water stairs, hitting it.
Yeah, one more zig. One water stairs. Yeah, water steps.
In art, Loony dead.
I spawn pillars. I'm pulling my pinch. Loony, that's the art play. I'm coming both steps. I'm going zig.
There's only two hill.
Despite what were some great early hills in that P2 to P3 train out of the Seattle Surge, now we see OpTic bringing it back and very well could be even, if not in somewhat of a A close game after our first set of rotations. Study, what'd you make of the communication there and the coordination in those last few HPs out of Chicago?
I love how the communication was so fluent. Like, you heard OpTic, they were trying to set up a pinch for that P5. And once they let Scump get in towards Art, he opened up with that kill. The callouts were coming in from Formo and Dashy exactly where they were spawning. So they were able to just chain all those kills together and eventually break that hard point. But it was the fact that they were able to hold that P4, even if a streak came in. The streak came in and they were still able to hold it down. So Surge, get some more streaks, because OpTic can hold their setup like that. Because right now, they're able to fight back in this game. We're going to have a tie ball game. But you see number eight, he's trying to flip those spawns. He's unfortunately going to drop, and that's going to go three down for OpTic.
Yeah, that's a huge loss. I mean, what if Scump wins that 1v1, and then all of the teammates drop inside of the hill? Maybe you're talking about flip spawns. So regardless, big moments coming through from Surge. And I got to ask you, man, I know we have a little bit of time as the breaking kind of moments happen in this first hardpoint. But what do you think have been the issues so far for Chicago now that we've got to see them play raids so many times? And losing kitchen, losing garage, hills of that nature.
Well, it's definitely like just their setup sometimes on certain hills. Like their P2 setup, it's all about like if they die once, they're automatically going to spawn out. You need to spread a little bit more, try to build those layers to when you're picking up those kills, you're still able to spawn in the back. And it's the same thing for P3. Just such a tight setup. Once one person drops, they're automatically going to spawn out. They need to spread their setups so they're able to die and at least spawn up and still have those spawns.
We'll see how they can possibly break it. I know their holds have maybe been somewhat questionable as of recently, but 40 points down, an opportunity to do it, but they pretty much slammed at the door. Prestinni finding two with the nade, pretty much everything but the gun. And how about the gunny there on the Scump, catching him off inside of that money window. So final 20 gonna go the way of Surge as OpTic now prepare once again for garage. We saw them get broke on this hill last time around. We'll see how this next setup looks to be. The struggles have been pretty prominent in these setups. But boy, what a hill this could be. They can grab the full 60. Here come the Surge through the weight room.
Yeah, they need to hold it because right now, OpTic is just not playing well. You have Envoy 6 and 18, Scump at 9 and 14. This is your SMG duo who's supposed to be just being aggressive on the map, winning a lot of those engagements. They were able to take down three, but here comes Gunless through gym side. He's going to get dropped, but it's looking like a couple players from Seattle just trying to flood on through this gym, but a lot of engagements are going in favor of OpTic. But Prestini's trying to set up the pinch. He's going to get taken down. Looney and Gunless go right through mid. Envoy's going to be the last one, and he's going to take down both players and eventually try to slow down that push from Seattle. As they do end up picking up this remaining 20 seconds, OpTic has to focus off the rotation.
Yeah, OpTic will refocus their attention now toward basketball, but Seattle going to be in a really good spot. When we talk about the way that this hardpoint has begun to lay out, breaking through majority of these hills. But I know we got to take a quick little gander there at the scorecard. Really for Surge, you're looking at Gunless, you're looking at Prestinni. Both having solid games, incredibly notable. That's 234 to 160. The major plays needed out of OpTic in order to bring this one back. As we'll see how the hold will be. Scump, first line of defense over toward the jungle sidewater. As well being cleared out right now from OpTic, as it seems to be the mid-push, possibly looking to try to unite inside of the kitchen. Surge goes strong through three, and now this could set up Formal for a nice few kills. Able to drop Octane off the rip. Has to get back with the teammates, because here they come. Into the blender they go, as OpTic finding all the kills necessary. Here comes the push from Surge, the trade. It appears that really once the dust begins to settle, it will be OpTic grabbing the remainder of those seconds, so they have brought it back for the most part. But here comes Looney, winning a big two. Major plays coming in from him, but Surge cannot win it there. They're going to be at about 246 if they grab every second left. It all comes down to Pit.
Now this is where that communication needs to come in for OpTic. They have one good push. One player's gonna push through pillars, he's gonna drop. Dash is gonna come through kitchen, able to take down two. Looney trying to go for the second. It's only gonna be on the Formal. Formal's gonna drop, and the Surge are gonna walk away with that first hard point. Just came down to a couple hills that OpTic were there on the previous setup. But they just didn't have good holds, man. And Surge just kept on breaking in, kept on getting that remaining junk time. they were able to close out that map number one.
I mean, I asked to come into this series. I said, hey, you know what? They're playing on the exact same map set that we saw just a week ago, kind of specifically referencing that opening hard point. And you said, hey, not too crazy. Kind of given the way that this series went last time around, how close the respawns were, maybe even as of late, how Chicago have looked on this specific map. It appears that, that Seattle have made the right call, at least to start things off. A major opening hardpoint victory, but I feel like we just kind of continue to say the same thing, Study. It's just kind of this echoing effect of just not being able to hold down these money hills, and obviously the SMGs, not a great performance here.
Yeah, they did a better job on that P4 right there at the very end. They had Envoy, who was pushed all the way out Tiki, so every single time they were getting kills, they're spawning them all the way at P1, all the way back Art. All they have to do is push through kitchen and through the back. It's just that P2 and that P3 hardpoint where their setups are just too tight. And once one player drops, they spawn out, it's automatically broken.
And what you see that on the scorecard, 11 seconds over on P2 is it for Chicago. And really when we talk about kitchen, how important that money hill can be for this particular map, it's not often going to lead to a victory. But Seattle getting the W that they needed to start off this series. Momentum heavily in their favor to start this one off. Folks, we've got ourselves some good old search and destroy. Up next, right after the break, stay with us.
Call of Duty League is presented by T-Mobile, now America's largest and fastest 5G network. Set your sights on the competition with T-Mobile, the leader in 5G. The Call of Duty League is presented by Zenni, the official eyewear for the CDL. Armor your eyes with Zenni Blocks blue light protection glasses by visiting zenni.com/gaming.
Oh boy, what a map one to start off this elimination series. We cannot stress it enough. You lose this series and you are in the elimination bracket. OpTic Chicago versus Surge, treating us to a great game one hardpoint. Let's go ahead and kind of reference back to what has been an interesting season so far for OpTic, just in regards to stage one, stage two, really where their KD ranks sit right now. Study, what do you make, man?
Just from top to bottom, man, they're some of the best players to ever touch Call of Duty. You have Dashy, who's second overall in KD. These guys have not been winning a lot of matches recently, but he's still overall number two. So the guy's just an unbelievable player. Sitting right next to him is going to be 4-1-6. And it's just insane, man. With both of those ARs on your team, picking up the kills that they do, it should be a lot easier than winning these maps, but just come down to these setups.
Yeah, and we take a look at the KDs for Surge. I know in comparison to when we look at stage one, stage two, I know we see what Loony with the last KD, 39th for Prestinni, 24th for Gunless. Really, when you look at what is kind of this graphic right now, it looks as if, well, Surge, hey, this should be a pretty easy series for OpTic, right? All things considered. But again, it's been this stage two.